Stephen Moore, CNN senior economics analyst and former Trump advisor, and Ken Rogoff. He is a professor of economics and public policy at Harvard and was chief economist at the International Monetary Fund. Gentlemen, good morning to you.
Hi, Victor.
Hey, Stephen, let me start with you in these numbers that we're getting. The president said on several occasions that he inherited a mess from the Obama administration. But let's look at the last 3 years of job growth during the Obama administration. In 2016, more than 2 million jobs, more than 2.6 million in 2015, the year before, nearly 3 million jobs. Is a million jobs in 6 months turning things around, or is he just keeping pace with the 2016 numbers here?
Well, this was a blockbuster jobs report. There's just no question about it. We not only saw a lot of new jobs created, we saw jobs almost throughout the economy in terms of different sectors of the economy, including manufacturing and food services and business services. So it was a great, and the other thing that was really positive is about this report was we finally saw a little bit of wage growth. And I would make the case to you, yeah, we had job growth under Barack Obama. What we didn't have is any wage growth. And I think that was one of the reasons Hillary Clinton lost the election. People just don't just want jobs. They want higher paying jobs. So this was, look, when you combine the, you know, the record high stock market with record low unemployment and record confidence in the economy right now, according to every survey, I think Trump deserves a lot of credit for this. And I think the economy has really finally started to shift into a higher gear.
All right, Ken, so you heard from Stephen there. What they're seeing now is the end of that stagnant wages, some wage growth. What do you see in the latest jobs report?
Well, it's a great job report, and I agree with Stephen Moore completely there. But I think the economy is like a giant ship that takes a long time to slow down or change course. And we're still in the Obama recovery. President Trump will get credit for it. But the fact is he's done very little so far in policy, except, I would say importantly, in the regulation area where it does encourage businesses. We can question some of the decisions he's made about the environment and such. So it does. There has been a boost in confidence. We don't see it in huge investment plans yet. We don't see it in really things that would really grow the economy in the long run. So I think the future lies ahead of what President Trump might or might not be able to accomplish.
So, Stephen, how much does a president credit does a president deserve for the jobs created during their term? If we're coming off 75 months of continuous consecutive job growth from the Obama administration and now coming into 6 months, adding a million jobs, how much of this credit goes to the president that the Dow closes above 22,000 on any given day?
Well, look, I think the presidents do deserve credit for what happens on their watch. Now, Donald Trump has only been president for 6 months or so, so, you know, it's still early in the game. I agree entirely with Ken that, you know, when the rubber really hits the road is whether he can get his economic plan passed. He has done some of the deregulation. That's helped a lot in the energy sector, for example, where we're seeing the coal industry come back and a lot of drilling and mining jobs. But I think that the big deal right now for the economy is getting this tax cut passed, especially given the failure Republicans had on Obamacare, which has been a big negative for the economy. You got to get this tax cut bill done. I'm a big advocate of it. I worked for on that plan with Donald Trump on the campaign. I think you'll see a big increase in growth and jobs and wages if we get that tax cut passed. And if we don't get it passed, by the way, I think some of those record high stock market rallies, you're going to see maybe a sell-off if investors and businesses don't think the Republicans can get their act together.
So, Ken, to you, your degree of confidence that this tax reform can happen. When Reagan worked to reform taxes, it took years to do, and he was far more popular than the current president. Is it possible? Are you confident that this can happen?
It's hard to be confident about anything in Washington these days, so no, I'm not confident. I do think the corporate tax reform, great idea. We have not just high corporate taxes, we have a bad system. It's part of why companies are keeping profits abroad. The individual income tax, I just don't see that as being a boost for the average American worker. I don't think it's, we're in that kind of economy that we were with Reagan. There's this grinding downward pressure on wages coming from globalization, mechanization, and, you know, running this play. We did it Reagan, we did it under Bush, doing it again. I don't think it's going to lead to that much growth.
Stephen, quickly to you.
I agree with, let me just say, I agree with that. I think, I think we both agree most of the, you know, the real juice from this tax cut really comes on the business side, where we have the highest corporate tax rate in the world. It is leading to businesses and factories leaving. And Ken, I've been trying to urge the White House and Congress, you know, focus on those business tax cuts. But you can't just do it for corporations. It also has to be for small businesses as well.
All right, Stephen, Ken, thank you
both.
Absolutely.
Great. Thank you.
All right, Christy.
Thank you.
All righty. Still.